Ladies and gentlemen, in today's era where globalization has happened, more family are moving to another country in search of a better and a more prosperous life. In these kinds of cases, ladies and gentlemen, an immigration created a first-gen immigration. First-gen immigration is a family that are foreign-born has relocated and a permanent citizen or a permanent residence in a certain country. And in these kinds of debate, ladies and gentlemen, we believe that this house, as a first-gen immigrant parent of color in a predominantly white country, would choose to live and raise children in an ethnic enclave. What exactly ethnic enclaves, ladies and gentlemen? Ethnic enclaves are communities with high concentration of one ethnic group. For example, in Chinatown, Chinatown consists of high concentration in Chinese population, ladies and gentlemen. Now, why exactly we believe that it will be the best for the interest of the kids to raise them in an ethnic enclave? Firstly, ladies and gentlemen, ethnic enclave is more suitable for the first-gen kids. How so? We believe in ethnic enclaves, there are certain criteria that are exclusive to the ethnic enclaves in itself. Firstly, sense of community is high in ethnic enclave, ladies and gentlemen. Other neighborhoods are more individualistic. Let's say that in New York itself, there are not ethnic enclaves. Let's say New Jersey, this environment are a more individualistic environment. This environment are less helpful in times of need and careless when there's new family move. And these kinds of helping environment are needed for the first gen family because they need assistance in the very first place. And this will be further explained by my second speaker. Now, secondly, why exactly the ethnic enclaves is work-based for the kids' interest? Firstly, a sense of identity is needed for this first-gen family kids, ladies and gentlemen. First-gen kids tend to question where did they belong. How exactly this happens, ladies and gentlemen? When they are moved to a certain country, of course that country has a certain criteria in physical appearance and different moral value and also different culture, ladies and gentlemen. And this type of kids who move there, they tend to question themselves because how so, ladies and gentlemen? Because of firstly physical difference, different moral value and different culture. And we believe that putting them in a ethnic enclave would be more beneficial in these kinds of debate. So, firstly, how exactly it will be beneficial? Firstly, the type of ethnic enclave can provide a support system. Firstly, they are more relatable. They are more relatability amongst first-gen kids. They went through the same things, and therefore they can help these kids in knowing their identity, in knowing what exactly where they belong, and make them feel like home, ladies and gentlemen. And secondly is the points of familiarity. Why exactly familiarity is important in this debate? We believe that when we put our kids and raise them in an ethnic enclave, they feel more familiar in their environment. Firstly, being around people with similar physical appearance, culture, etc. can bring comfort towards kids. Why we are saying that, ladies and gentlemen? In our mind alone, in our psychology, we strive for familiarity, ladies and gentlemen. We wanted to belong in a certain community. We wanted to feel acceptance. It is within our needs, ladies and gentlemen. What happened when we don't have these kinds of needs? We will lose our sense of home, and therefore we feel less motivated. We feel we are not accepted. We are not happier in general. And these kinds of feelings is not needed, and it is not beneficial for the kids in their development years, ladies and gentlemen. And we believe that these kinds of familiarity, these kinds of comforts can be provided in ethnic enclave due to their members being a familiar ethnicity. Therefore they have a similar physical appearance, they have a similar value, and they have a similar culture, ladies and gentlemen. And we believe that in these kinds of case, it is needed by the kids. And secondly, ladies and gentlemen, why when we are putting them and raising them in ethnic enclave, it will maintain a cultural value within themselves. Why exactly it is important for kids in this case to maintain their cultural value? We believe that a certain kids must have a moral value within themselves, ladies and gentlemen. It will be a more better if they have a certain guidance if they wanted to live in a society. And we believe that ethnic enclave can maintain the value that their previous state culture has given them, ladies and gentlemen. And therefore, they are more capable to put themselves in a society. They are capable of behaving in a certain society, because we believe that this cultural value will make them a more disciplined, for example, a more human kids, ladies and gentlemen. How exactly? Because we believe that the culture in this kinds of scenario. Acts as a boundaries within them. They will guide them to know exactly what is right and what is wrong. And we believe that in these kinds of case, it is needed within the kids themselves to know what is right and what is wrong. And the benefits and that kinds of sense of right and wrong will be beneficial for the kids in the future, in order for them to adapt to a newer society, for example. And in this debate, we already proved to you why exactly ethnic enclave is suitable for first-gen kids due to its high in sense of community. We also proved to you that raising them in ethnic enclave will give them a sense of identity, and maintaining cultural value will be beneficial in this debate. Thank you.
Mr. and Madam, here I'm standing as the Deputy Prime Minister on our today's debate under today's motion, which is this house as a first generation immigrant parent of color in a predominantly white country will choose to live and raise children in an ethnic enclave. So we believe that we need to propose this motion, and we believe that this is the best because this is going to be beneficial, whether it's for the kids, for the parents, or for the society overall. And then we also see that even though they're living in this kind of ethnic enclave, it doesn't mean that they are untouchable, or it doesn't mean that they don't see or they don't understand. Or they don't see what is actually happening around the world. They would still be approachable, and they would still know what is happening around the world. But the difference is that here we give them the benefit, which is we give them the strong sense of their identity. We give them the strong base for them to be able to adapt later on this big world with the value of their community, ladies and gentlemen. So my previous speaker has told you before about how this motion is going to bring benefits towards these parents and these children, ladies and gentlemen. And now I'm going to explain to you how is this going to build a sense of community and why is this going to be beneficial. So we see here that this is going to build a sense of community. So how is it likely to be happen? So when you're living in a community with the same identity to you, with the same background, with the same struggles, you would feel like it's home to you, and you feel like it's a familiar place to you. You feel accepted, and you're living with people which having the same struggle with you. So it means that you can relate more to them. By relating more to the people there in that society, it means that you're going to have the sense of belongings to the community. So why is this important? Because when you have sense of belongings in the community, it would create a positive environment. A positive environment means that you're going to be involved in the community without being forced. You're going to involve there because you feel like you have the same background to them, and then the community will be also uplifting your personality there. So this is an exclusive case in the proposition side, because we see that when people are not living in this kind of ethnic enclave, they're going to be separated and they're going to live individually, which means that it would create some kind of they would be facing some kind of ignorance from the society, and it will be harder for them to strive. So why is that important for us to give this sense of community, or to create this sense of community in an ethnic enclave to these people, these immigrants, ladies and gentlemen? So firstly, we should see why is actually people want to be immigrant, or why they're migrating to certain countries, ladies and gentlemen. We often see that these people are usually migrating to another country, to another big cities, because they want to have a better life, they want to have a better job, they want to live better, they want to be prosper. So it means that they have to strive in that country, they have to deal with this new area. They are coming to an area where they don't have any idea what is actually happening here and what they should do, ladies and gentlemen. By creating this ethnic enclave, these families, these new families that are coming from outside, that are migrating to this big city, they're going to be supported, they are going to be to get knowledge from those people in that ethnic enclave about what they should do, or what are the criteria that they need to work and live in this society, in this city, and things like that. So it would help them to prepare themselves to face the outside world by living in this kind of ethnic enclave. And then it also will help this new families to raise their children. And we see that this is not some kind of where we're trying to inhibit their rights, or we're trying to inhibit them from being outside of the world. We see that this is a chance for them to be prepared before, because we see that when you're different when the other people outside of your community, it will be harder for you to strive, because you have no idea what they are having, you have no idea what is the criteria that is needed by them. So thus it is more beneficial for them if they're living in this kind of ethnic enclave and then be prepared, and then it will make them be easier to adapt. So by that, we believe that by creating this kind of ethnic enclave, it would create the sense of belonging, which will become an uplifting society for every actors in this motion, which is the children, the parents, and also the society. So based on that, we're back to propose. Thank you.